Good morning, students. Welcome back to online classes. We have started our ninth chapter, rational numbers. And in the last video, I have given the introduction, the concepts, some concepts I have explained about rational numbers. Now let us start our exercise 9.1. See, the first question is list five rational numbers between. It is given as -1 and 0. List five rational numbers between -1 and 0. See, in the number line, the midpoint is 0 and here it is -1. There are a lot of infinite numbers between -1 and 0. Just we have to find 5 rational numbers between these two numbers. So because to find the 5 rational numbers between -1 and 0, I am writing -1 as -6/6. The meaning of this is -1, I am multiplying and dividing with 6. So this will be -6/6. Same wise, I have done it for -1, so I have to do it for 0 also. So this will become, 0 will be 0/6, because 0 into 6/6 is 6 into 0 is 0/6. So 0 I have written it as 0/6, and -1 I have written it as -6/6. So now we can find the rational numbers between -6 and 0 here. So the 5 rational numbers between -1, I have written it as -6/6. So after -6/6, it is -5/6, -4/6, -3/6, -2/6, -1/6, and the last one is 0/6, that is 0. So these are the 5 rational numbers between -1 and 0 here. So in this way we have to see 5 rational numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 rational numbers here. So in this they have given to find the rational numbers between two numbers, that is -1 and 0. So I have written for -1 as -6/6, that is I have multiplied and divided -1 with 6 already, and also I have written multiplied and divided the 0 also with 6. So 6 into 0 is 0 and 6 is the denominator. So it is between -6/6 and 0/6. So the rational numbers between -6/6, that is -1, and 0/6 is 0. So these are the 5 rational numbers between -1 and 0. So our next question, B part is given as -2 and -1. So here for -2, I am going to write it as, because I have to find 5 rational numbers. So I am going to multiply this -2 into 6/6 again. So this will become -12/6. Same, -1, I am going to write it as -1 into 6/6. You can multiply with any number, but I want 5 rational numbers, so I am taking 6 here. So -6/6. So this is -12/6, -11/6, -10/6, -9/6, -8/6, -7/6, and next one is -6/6, that is -1. So these are the 5 rational numbers between -2 and -1. This -12/6 is -2. So these are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 rational numbers between -2 and -1. So in this way you have to solve the questions. Means 2 numbers are given, 2 integers are given, whether it is positive or negative. To find the rational numbers between those 2 numbers, we have to do this procedure. One more question, they have given 4 questions. Let me do one more question. The third part. So see, for your third part, it is given as -4/5, C part, -4/5, and it is given as -2/3. minus 4 by 5 and minus 2 by 3. You can see here the denominators are different. So first we have to make the denominator same. So for that I am multiplying the first rational number with the second rational number denominator with 3 here, with 3 here. So it is minus 12 by 15. And the same minus 2 by 3 into I am going to multiply this rational number with the first rational number denominator. So it is 5 to make the denominator same. So here it is minus 10 by 15. So you can see here the denominators are same. Now between these, see minus 12 by 15, minus 11 by 15 and minus 10 by 15. Here only one rational number. Only one rational number is there. But we want 5 rational numbers. So let us go to the next number. See minus 12 by 15 into 2 into 2. See minus 24 by 15. 2's are 30. And the second one minus 10 by 15 into 2 into 2. So minus 20 by again 30. Minus 24 minus 20. So minus 24 by 30. Minus 23 by 30. Minus 22 by 30. Minus 21 by 30. And here minus 20 by 30. So here again see 1, 2, 3 rational numbers are there. Here we got 1 rational number. Here we got 3 rational numbers. But we want 5 rational numbers. So let us proceed to the next number. Here we have made the denominator same. I have got only one rational number here. I have multiplied the two rational numbers with 2. So now let us multiply with 3 here. Continuing for our 5 rational numbers. Here it is minus 12 by 15 into 3 into 3. See here minus 26 by 45. Next one is minus 10 by 15 into 3 into 3. See here it is minus 30 by 45. So let us write the rational numbers between these two. Here we got only 3 rational numbers. Here we got only 1 rational number. And let us see how many rational numbers we are going to get here. So here minus 26 by 45, minus 25 by 45, minus 24 by 45, minus 23 by 45, minus 22 by 45, 26, we have to write it in the reverse order. Minus 30 by 45, minus 29 by 45, minus 28 by 45, minus 27 by 45, minus 26 by 45. See here also we got 3 rational numbers. So let us go for the next one. 1 minute. 12 threes are 36, it is not 26 here. So here it is 36. So minus 36 by 45, minus 35 by 45, minus 34 by 45, 33 by 45, minus 32 by 45, minus 31 by 45, here minus 30 by 45. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we got the 5 rational numbers here. So the 5 rational numbers are the 5 rational numbers are minus 35 by 45, minus 34 by 45, minus 33 by 45, minus 32 by 45 and minus 31 by 45. See, in this question they have given two numbers, that two rational numbers, that is minus 4 by 5 and minus 2 by 3. First we have to make the denominator same. So I have multiplied the first rational number with the second rational number denominator and second rational number with the first rational number denominator, and I have got the answer as minus 12 by 15 and minus 10 by 15. between these two I have got only one rational number, but I want five rational numbers. So I have proceeded for the next multiplication. So I have multiplied both the rational numbers with 2. So I have got it as minus 24 by 30 and minus 20 by 30. But the rational numbers between these two are only 3 in number. But I want 5. So after 2, I have went to the next number 3. So when I multiplied with 3, I have got the 5 rational numbers here. So this is your answer. Like this only, 4th question, 1 by 2 and 2 by 3. Hope so you can complete it by yourself. Now proceeding to the next question, second question. So here second question is, write four more rational numbers. They have given a pattern here. See, second question A part, they have given a pattern as minus 3 by 5. Minus 6 by 10, minus 9 by 15, here minus 12 by 20. After this, we have to write 4 more rational numbers continuing with this pattern. You can see on the top, it is a 3 table. See, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12. So, next one will be 3 fives are 15, 3 sixes are 18, 3 sevens are 21. 3 8s are 24, because they have asked four more rational numbers, so I have written the 4. Next, 5. You can see the table of 5 here. See, 5, 10, 15, 20. So here 25, 30, 35 and 40. So this is your 4 more rational numbers after this pattern of rational numbers. Next, the B part. They have given it as minus 1 by 4, minus 2 by 8, minus 3 by 12. See the numerators, 1, 2, 3. So next one will be minus 4, next minus 5, minus 6, minus 7 by 4 table, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12, 4 4s are 16, 4 5s are 20, 4 6s are 24, 4 7s are here 28. So this is your answer for your B part. They have given a pattern here. We have to write 4 more rational numbers. So continuing with that pattern, in the first one, in the numerator, it is a 3 table. So I have written the 3 table. In the denominator, it is a 5 table. So I have written the 5 table. In the second one, the first, in the numerator, it is 1, 2, 3 numbers. Go on. And in the denominator, it is a 4 table. So I have written the 4 table, continuing with the 4 table. So like this, we have to complete our C and D part. Only 2 questions are left out, so I think you can complete it. Now continuing with the third question. Give 4 equivalent rational numbers. Third question. Give 4 equivalent rational numbers. See, first one, they have given it as minus 2 by 7. The numbers which are equivalent to this 2 by 7, we have to write, that is also 4 equivalent rational numbers. So, you can use this method. You can use this method. You can multiply the numerator and denominator with numbers. And write it like, see, minus 2 by 7. Here, if I am going to multiply with 1, this will be minus 2 by 7. If I am going to go to the next number, see, minus 4 by 14. If I am going to go to the next number, 3. Means, you can write the table of 2 up to 4 times and table of 7 up to 4 times also. So, let us do it in that way. So here is equals to, because equivalent, so that's why equal to sign. So 2 2's are 4, next 2 3's are 6 here, 2 4s are 8. Only 3. Next 2 5s are 10. Bye 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 bye. Here 7 1s are 7. 7 2s are 14. 7 3s are 21. 7 4s are 28. 7 5s are 35. So these are the 4 equivalent fractions which are equal to -2/7. Next to the B part, 5 by -3. Again we can do the same. 5 1s are 5 here, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20, 5 5s are 25. So bye 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 bye. -3. 1s are, so minus sign, -3. 2s are -6. Next 3s are -9, 4s are -12, 5s are -15. So in this way I think you can do your C and D part also. Same wise, just you have to write the equivalent fraction. For that you can write the table of the numerator. Up to 4 equivalent fractions we want. So I have written it up to 5. So like this we can write the numerator table up to 5 and denominator table up to 5. This is your third question. I am leaving the third and fourth question for you. Let me write one more. 4 by 9. See, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12, 4 4s are 16, 4 5s are 20 here. 9 1s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 9 3s are 27, 9 4s are 36, 9 5s are 45. Next D part, minus, only 3 questions they have given. Only 3 questions they have given, so I have completed all the 3. Now next to 4th question. Your 4th question, you have to represent the given rational number on a number line. So draw a number line and represent the following numbers. 4th question, A part, 3 by 4. When I was discussing the concepts of representing the given rational number on a number line, I have explained this for you. Once again, see, we have to represent this 3 by 4 on a number line. So let us draw a number line. Here in the middle, 0 here, here minus 1, here minus 2, here 1, here 2. So for representing this, we don't know where 3 by 4 comes. So first let us, at the side, let us divide this 3 by 4. See, 3 divided by 4. Because 3 is small, so point here 0. 4 7s are 28. 2 5s are 20. So it is 0.75. I am leaving this 5 and I am just taking after the decimal number only 1 point. So it is 0.7. So 0.7 means it lies between. Means we can write here. We can write here 3 by 4 is equals to 0.7. Therefore 3 by 4 lies between 0 and 1. Because this is 0.7 and I told you after, before the decimal, that is on the left hand side. What number is there? The number lies between those two numbers. See, if it is 3.7. So this 3.7 lies between 3 and 4. If it is 11.5, this 11.5 lies between 11 and 12. So what number this is there on the left hand side of the decimal number? So that rational number lies between those two numbers. So this 3 by 4, it is 0.7. So it lies between 0 and 1, and I have also told you, you have to see the denominator of 4. So we have to divide the space between the 0 and 1 4 times, because here the denominator is 4. If the denominator is 7, we have to divide it into 7 parts. If the denominator is 8, we have to divide it into 8 parts. Now here it is 4, so we have to divide the space between 0 and 1 4 times. So 1 here, 2 here, 3 here. See, 1 2 3 4. So here it is 1 by 4 2 by 4. Let me write a little big. So here this will be 1 by 4, 2 by 4, next 3 by 4, and here 4 by 4 will be 1. So here it is 1. So this is your 3 by 4 part. So here your 3 by 4 lies between 0 and 1. One more question, B part. Minus 5 by 8. Minus 5 by 8. So again, let us again draw number line 0 here. Minus negative sign is there for the rational number. So it comes on the left hand side of the rational numbers. So let us write 1 here. So 1 here. I have written only 1. You can write more than 1. Let me divide it. See, minus 5 divided by 8. So here it is also small. So 0 here, 50. 56. So 8 6 is up. 48 here. So minus here 2. So I'm taking only 0.6. So minus 5 by 8 is equals to 0.6. Therefore minus 5 by 8 lies between 0 and 1. Again 0.6, so it lies between 0 and 1. Here it is 8, so we have to divide it, minus 1. Here we have to divide the space between 0 and 8, 8 times. So let me take this minus 1 to a little bit extent. So minus 1 here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 parts. So let us write the 5 by 8. So it is minus 1 by 8, minus 2 by 8, minus 3 by 8, minus 4 by 8, minus 5 by 8, minus 6 by 8, minus 7 by 8, and here minus 8 by 8 is 1. So here is your minus 5 by 8. I hope you understood, everyone, how I have done it. First, the given fraction, I have divided it. I have seen the number. If it is 0.6, so it lies between 0 and 1. And if it is other than 1.5 or 2.8 or something like that, so it lies between both the other two numbers. Here it is 0.6, so it lies between 0 and 1. And the denominator is 8 here, so I have to divide the space between 0 and 1, 8 parts. So I have divided into 8 parts and I have written the numbers, rational numbers, minus 1 by 8, 2 by 8, minus 3 by 8, and so on. I got the space where minus 5 by 8 has been there. So I have marked it. In this way, you have to do your third and fourth one also. It is minus 7 by 4 and the next one is 7 by 8. I hope so you can complete the third and fourth one. So let us continue in our next period.